Lord, we pray over the tables, Lord. Each one of these chairs is a soul without you, Lord. It's an existence without any meaning, without any purpose. Lord, this can't be it. This cannot be it. People cannot just spend their grown-up life in addiction, pain in it, and then just die to nothing, Lord. Lord, get it, strengthen us. Give us an urgency, Lord. Lord, their lives might be lost now in this life, but it don't mean that they're lost in the next life, Lord. Draw them to you, Lord. Draw them to you. When I was a kid, one of the reasons why I didn't drink, I always pictured what I never wanted to be. Lonely, abusive and a drunk. Within 3 to 4 years, I was a full-blown working addict. Have a drink before I went to work. I'd drink heavily on a night, and I did this for a number of years until
it got worse and got worse. Finally, I collapsed. See, for the last 18 months, 2 years, I was losing a lot of blood. I get taken into hospital, and the doctor says, if you don't stop drinking, you could have 6 months to a year. We don't know if anything can help you. Within an hour of leaving the hospital after the detoxing, I was in a pub drinking within half an hour. So I kind of resigned myself, that's it, then I'm just gonna die.
I then became a vagrant homeless, down and out, just waiting for my time to check out. I remember a friend of mine called the emergency psychiatric unit, because I was stood in the middle of the road hoping for cars to run me over to die. I didn't want to die, I was scared to die, but I couldn't live anymore.
You know, every day is different. Wake up in the morning and offer myself to the Lord and just kind of try to be ready for whatever He might have in mind. And it's always a privilege when the Lord invites me into something He's going to do.
So I'm in the town one Saturday morning and I'm roaming about as usual. I've got myself a drink and I goes and I just sits down on this bench. I've got nobody, lost everything. Addicted to alcohol, and I'm arguing with God, and I'm saying, you know, God, if you are real and this is the purpose of life, what kind of purpose is this? And I looks up and I'm sat opposite a church, and out of the corner of my eye I sees this young lad walking up to me, and he comes up to me and he says, do you know why Jesus died? So inside I'm like, you've got to be kidding. So then he tells me that Jesus died to take away my sin, to take away this pain, to give me peace, and then just walked away. So by this time, I'm really under pressure. I'm thinking, what is going on here? So I thought, I'm gonna get a drink. I goes, gets a drink, I comes back and sits on this bench. And the bench that I've been sat on, there's a young lad sat there, a different lad, never seen him before. So I sits down next to him, and he says, do you want to go for something to eat at my brother's? My mind's worked out. If I get into his brother's house, I can either get more drink or I can steal something to buy more drink. So I said, yeah, sure. So we jumped up. We're walking away, I'm talking to him. We've walked across this field. And he's walking me towards this church that I've been sat opposite. And I'm thinking, this can't be right. He said, just knock on that door and we'll get something to eat. I puts down my drink, I turns round, this kid's disappeared. The lad has just vanished, he's not there no more. So I knocks on the door, a proper monk answers the door, and he goes, I am Brother Sebastian. So this lad had said, don't you got my brothers, but he meant these spiritual brothers, this Catholic monk order. He takes me into this room, and he sits me down, and he does not even give me a chance. And I can't help it, it comes out of me, what's been going on in me heart. And this monk says, I'm going to pray for you. And he starts to pray about this man called Jesus. And he starts to pray about, can Jesus come and help me? Can Jesus come and clean me? And as he's praying, something that changes inside me. I walked out of there like I never had a drink in my life. My bleeding stopped. I dodged my intestines, healed, stopped. That day I put down drink and I walked out of that church and I never drank again. My life had changed. Within 24 hours, I had a place to live. It gave me a Gospel of Matthew, and I took it away and I was reading it like you'd never read before.
And every page I turn, it says, I love you, I love you, I love you. No one in the life had said, I love you like that.
Something resonated in me like, this is it, this is the truth. This is the thing that you've been searching for. This is the answer to your broken heart, to your broken soul.
Well, in less than a week, he was back. He said, do you have anything else like that? I said, okay. So I gave him the Gospel of John, then the Gospel of Luke, then the Acts of the Apostles. I said, well, at this point, I might as well give him the whole thing. So I did, and he was eating it up.
I'm at the hostel. I've got an old beat-up radio with me. So I've turned it on, and the first thing I hear is, and next is Dr. Michael Youssef, who's passionately proclaiming the uncompromised truth. And my first thought was, who is this guy to tell me what the truth is? And passionately, and then this man's voice comes off and he starts talking. He starts talking about Christ. And straight away I understand that. What his authority is, it's not any authority of himself, but he's speaking on authority on this man of Christ. And it's the stuff that Jesus has done that's the uncompromised truth. And when Dr. Michael Youssef talks about it, I got a full understanding of what happened on that cross.
And from then on, every day my morning started with a teaching from Dr. Michael Youssef. And this voice proclaims the truth.
And that was a turning point in my life.
Next thing I know, some few weeks or months later, he said, Father Sebastian, I've just signed up for this Bible college. I'm off like in 2 days or something. I'm like, oh, good. You know, it was a great thing to see that just more and more fruit coming out, that the Lord was moving his heart to say yes to more and to go deeper.
For the last 2.5 years, I've been preparing myself to this point. I've been through Bible college. I've come back and I'm working. I run a soup kitchen now where 100 people get fed. Homeless, addicts, refugees, working girls, we clothe them, we help house them. And I walk the streets with these girls out there, and I'll pray on them streets. I'll talk to them. I'll tell them about Christ. I'll pray with them. Christ hates sin, but he loves the sinner. And we will also. I've preached a couple of times, and when I stand up, there's something inside me that passionately proclaiming the compromised truth, and it resounds in me. And I think, you know what, Michael? I'm doing it today as well. And if that message can change an alcoholic's life around, it can turn a Muslim's life around in Saudi Arabia, in Kuwait, Lebanon, Bradford, Manchester, London. And Dr. Michael is seeing that need, and he's created this ministry called The Navigator, where we can get the gospel into the homes. The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. This is a worker now. This is an amazing, amazing thing that can be used massively in my community. My ministry's only starting off here, but I thank Dr. Michael Youssef for what he's poured into my life. I could be sat in a different church now, but I'm not. I'm sat in the right church, doing the right ministry for the right God, because I heard the right message from Dr. Michael Youssef. And every day is a gift, and I intend to use it as a gift.